In the session, I'll be detailing you about virus types. So time I was telling you about viruses types, there are basically two types of virus based upon the presence of genetic material. If you remember, I've told you in the virus structure that in virus structure, you have nucleic acid, and nucleic acid is surrounded by capsid, and capsid is made up of protein. And when you talk about that particular nucleic acid, the nucleic acid can be DNA or it can be RNA. And whatever it's present, remember both of the things are not present. So either it can be DNA or it can be RNA. So whatever it's present will be the genetic material of that particular virus. Let's suppose DNA is present, DNA will work as genetic material of virus. If RNA is present, RNA will work as genetic material of viruses. What happens in our body is, all of our bodies, the DNA is the genetic material. So I'm telling you one important line. That DNA is genetic material in most of the organisms except few viruses where RNA will be the genetic material. So RNA and DNA can be the genetic material of viruses. Now if the RNA is the genetic material, the viruses are called riboviruses. But if DNA is the genetic material of the viruses are called deoxyviruses. So based upon the presence of DNA or RNA, we classify viruses into two types. One are called deoxyviruses and next are called riboviruses. Deoxyviruses are again two types. It can be double-stranded DNA or it can be single-stranded DNA. So they are double-stranded DNA virus or single-stranded DNA virus. Similarly, you can have double-stranded RNA virus or you can also have single-stranded RNA virus. Now, I will illustrate some of the examples which you don't know, because most of the exams they would ask you, they'll give you some name, they will give you some, let's suppose herpes virus. So herpes virus is what? It is double-stranded DNA virus. They would ask you what is TMV. TMV is single-stranded RNA virus. You will have to remember some of the examples. When you talk about double-stranded DNA viruses, you have adenoviruses, you have herpes viruses. Herpes is a disease which is sexually transmitted. Then you have pox viruses, cauliflower mosaic viruses. Remember one important fact, cauliflower mosaic viruses, it's happening in cauliflower. And tobacco mosaic virus is happening in tobacco. Both are plants, and most of the plant viruses are single-stranded RNA, but you also can see in TMV. So most of the plant viruses are single-stranded, what you call RNA viruses. But cauliflower mosaic virus is one of the exceptions. Remember this, that most of the plant viruses, including TMV viruses, are single-stranded RNA. But you have this one particular important exception, which is called cauliflower mosaic viruses. When you talk about single-stranded DNA viruses, you have parvoviruses. They are single-stranded DNA. When you talk about double-stranded RNA virus, one important name is coming up. It's reovirus. So reoviruses are double-stranded RNA virus. In single-stranded RNA virus, I've already told you, you have TMV, you have influenza virus, and one another important virus which is called retrovirus. And retrovirus includes HIV virus, which causes AIDS. So HIV virus is basically single-stranded RNA virus. Now when you talk about, I've already told you, plant viruses are single-stranded RNA. This is only the exception. Now you have bacteriophages, so the virus which kills bacteria are double-stranded DNA. You will have to remember this particular thing, that bacteriophages are made up of double-stranded DNA. When you talk about animal viruses, it can be anything. It can be single-stranded RNA, it can be double-stranded RNA, or it can be double-stranded DNA. So animal viruses can be all these three. Plant viruses are mostly single-stranded RNA viruses. Bacteriophages are mostly double-stranded DNA viruses. So in your session, you will have to discuss about the details of TMV and bacteriophages. So in next session, I'll be starting up with the details of TMV, that is tobacco mosaic virus.